الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله، ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب، ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب، ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب. الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات طوبى لهم، طوبى لهم وحسن مآب.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. إن الحمد لله أحمده تعالى وأستعين به وأستغفره وأستهديه، وأعوذ بالله العلي العظيم من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. ثم أما بعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Dear brothers and dear sisters, inshallah we're gonna start tonight our inshallah good journey or blessed journey the تفسير القرآن الكريم. Inshallah tonight we're gonna start with سورة الفاتحة إن شاء الله رب العالمين. And I would like you to be patient with me, inshallah, in this good journey to understand more about the message of Allah, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Holy Quran. And if you understand the Holy Quran, this is what we need. We got the message. We got the message. Inshallah, our journey will start tonight with Surah Al-Fatiha. It is very important surah, the greatest chapter in the Holy Quran. And if you understand Surah Al-Fatiha, I can say you understand 50% of the Quran. 50% of the Quran. Because Surah Al-Fatiha talk about all the meaning of the Holy Quran. Whatever in the Quran, it is all in Surah Al-Fatiha. Let me recite it first in the right way, Arabic, then we'll give you its meaning in English from Nur al-Bayan Tafsir, and then I will go with you inshallah this 1 hour in details about just Surah Al-Fatiha. And later inshallah, if we'll be alive all of us, we're gonna start Surah Al-Baqarah from next week inshallah. Every week we're gonna talk 1 hour about the Tafsir, the interpretation of the Holy Quran, and we'll try to understand the grammar in Arabic, understand its meaning, the letters, why that word comes in that ayah, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did mean when he talk about that. فَلِتْ سَيْ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. The beginning, as I put in my tafsir here, tafsir Nur al-Bayan, the surah started with the praising of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and glorifying of Him. Started with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, in the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala named Himself Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, by the name of Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Allah did not say by the name of Shadid al-Iqab, the one which is His severe, His punishment is severe. He did not talk about the punishment, the hellfire. He started the Quran with Rahmah. Ar-Rahman, the most beneficent, the most merciful. الرحمن الرحيم. And this is a point we have to understand it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is Rahman and He is Rahim. Let's jump, just to go very fast with its meaning in English, then we'll go in details inshallah. Alhamdulillah, all the hamd, all the praises and thanks are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Allah started with Alif Lam. One of the names of Surah Al-Fatiha, Surah Al-Hamd. The chapter of praising. Alhamd, all the hamd due to Allah, all the praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why he started with Alif Lam. Kulli alhamd, all the hamd belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. Rabbil Alameen. All the praises and thanks be to Allah. Rabbil Alameen, the Lord of the mankind, jinn, and all that exists. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, again, praising of Allah. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, the compassionate, the merciful. His Rahman, His Rahim. Malik Yawm al-Din, the only owner of the only owner and ruling of the day of judgment, the day of recompense. He's the only one, he owned the day of judgment. We're going to talk in that in details now. Come now to the worship. We worship Allah alone. Khususiyya. Iyaka anta. Just you. We worship you. We worship Allah alone, the one with whom we seek help. Iyaka na'bud wa iyaka nasta'in. We seek help from you, O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim, when we say that, the shield of the believers. O Allah, guide us to the straight path, to the straight way. We're going to explain that right now. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. The path of those upon whom you have bestowed favor, not the path of those who earned your anger. There is no delil saying, to be honest with you, because some مفسرين they say that المغضوب عليهم the Jewish and الضالين in Nasara. There is no delil saying that. That's why I put it in my tafsir. Again, I will read it for you. Not the path of those who earned your anger. Anybody could be Muslim too. Do you think if any Muslim disobeyed Allah, he will not earn the anger of Allah? He will earn the anger of Allah. Why do you put Jewish people? There is no delil saying that. And the mufassirin, they get it from their mind. وَلَا الضَّالِّينَ nor of those who went astray. They said the Christian. There is no delil. That's why I put it in my tafsir for anybody. If anybody makes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala angry, he will get the wrath of anger of Allah. The anger of Allah, Allah will be angry of him. Even Muslims. And those who went astray, not just but I can explain it inshallah in details. Let me close this now and go in details about Surah Al-Fatiha now. Just, I make it just not to make too many pages, because see how big is it? And I make it mukhtasar too. From 4 volumes in Arabic. And see how big is it? Subhanallah. Surah Al-Fatiha, it is Makki chapter. If somebody asked you, is it Makki or Madani? La, it is Makki chapter. Makki means what? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam received it while he was at Mecca. That's why we say Makki chapter. And inshallah, we'll, in our journey, when we talk about the Quran, we'll tell you the difference between the Makki and the Madani, the Layli and the Nihari, the Quran during the night time and the daytime. Subhanallah. Some Quran Rasulullah received it while he was above the mountain, in the valley, during the daytime, the night time, in Jerusalem, when he was in Isra'u al-Mi'raj. Subhanallah. And Mecca and Medina. Subhanallah. We're going to give you the, inshallah, details about that. It is a Makki chapter. It's verses, 7 verses. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَاكَ سُرْتَ الْحِجْرِ وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَاكَ سَبْعًا مِنَ الْمَثَانِي 7 repeatedly verses. This Mathani means repeatedly verse. We recite it too many times in our salah, right? How many times in our salah? Namaz, prayer, we are reciting Surah Al-Fatiha. 17 times in Salat Al-Farida. And if you count with the Nawafil, it's going to be 29 times day and night. Day and night. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said it in the Quran. Sab'an min al-Mathani. Al-Mathani means repeatedly verses. We repeat it because it's very important verses. I'm going to tell you why now. Surah Al-Fatiha, number 5, Surah, Rasulullah received it from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said Surah Al-Alaq, Iqra, Surah Al-Muddathir, Surah Al-Muzzammil, and then Surah Al-Fatiha comes number 5, the 5th Surah, Rasulullah received it from Allah Azza wa Jal through Jibreel alayhi salam. Surah Al-Fatiha, Makki, 7 repeatedly verses, and 5th Surah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did it from Allah Azza wa Jal. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was telling one of the Sahaba, would you like to learn the greatest chapter in the Holy Quran? And they said, yes, please, Ya Rasulullah. Tell me what is the greatest chapter of the Holy Quran, Ya Rasulullah. Bismillah. And Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he told him, لَأُعَلِّمَنَّكَ أَعْظَمْ سُورَةِ فِي الْقُرْآنِ, I will teach you the greatest chapter in the Holy Quran. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recited to him الحمد لله رب العالمين, سورة الحمد, سورة الفاتحة, the greatest chapter in the Holy Quran. If you know the value of سورة الفاتحة, brother, sister, you're gonna read it for yourself, for your family too many times a day, not just in the prayer. If you know the value of this surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَاكَ, indeed, we give you, O Muhammad, سَبْعًا مِنَ الْمَثَانِي, 7 verses, 7 repeatedly verses, وَا in Arabic, وَا القرآن العظيم, يعني 7 مِنَ الْمَثَانِي equal to القرآن الكريم. See how it's a very important surah. We give you 7 repeatedly verses, plus القرآن الكريم, one in a scale, the whole entire Quran, different scale, they are equal. سورة الفاتحة equal to the whole entire Quran. وَلَقَدْ أَهْتَيْنَاكَ سَبْعًا مِنَ الْمَثَانِ وَالْقُرْآنِ الْعَظِيمِ. صلى الله عليه وسلم قال, والذي نفسي بيده, ما أنزل الله في التوراة ولا الإنجيل والزبور ولا الفرقان مثلها, إنها السبع المثاني, narrated by Imam Ahmad. رسول الله swear by Allah, which is رسول الله's soul in his hand, الذي نفسي بيده, Allah did not send surah in the Torah, the Bible, the Psalms of David, and even in the Quran, like Surah Al-Fatiha, the greatest surah ever. Remember that I told you before, Surah Al-Fatiha, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent 4 books, the Psalms of David, the Zabur of Dawood alayhi salam, the Torah of Moses, the Bible of Jesus, Al-Injil, and the Holy Quran, Al-Furqan. 4 books and 100 scrolls, Suhuf. These 100 scrolls, he gave Adam 10 scrolls. Prophet Chief, he gave him 50 scrolls alone. Prophet Idris, he gave him 30 scrolls. 50, 30, 10. How many now? 90. And he gave Sayyidina Ibrahim 10 scrolls. Now 100 scrolls plus these 4 books, all of them, it's their meanings all in Surah Al-Fatiha. See? Even the Quran, Muhaymin, the Quran canceled all the books before. نسخ الكتب السابقة. If the Quran gonna be like that, and Surah Al-Fatiha equal to the Quran, means Surah Al-Fatiha equal to the whole books of Allah, the revelation. All the revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to know the value of your Quran, the value of what you have. Surah Al-Fatiha, it is Umm al-Quran, the mother of the Holy Quran. Surah Al-Fatiha, it is the mother of the Holy Quran. Imagine that, you without your mother, you will not exist. From where you gonna come? Surah Al-Fatiha, it is the mother of the Holy Quran, means like the message is telling me like the whole entire Quran comes from Surah Al-Fatiha. Not Surah Al-Fatiha comes from the Quran. The mother, it is the mother of the whole entire Quran. Means the whole entire Quran comes from the womb of Surah Al-Fatiha. The mother of the Holy Quran. It is As-Sab' Al-Mathani. The names, now I'm telling you the names of Surah Al-Fatiha now. As-Sab' Al-Mathani, the seven repeatedly verses. It is Al-Waqiyah, Al-Kafiyah. Al-Waqiyah, it is protection. It is cure, Al-Shafiyah. If you are sick, read Surah Al-Fatiha. Allah will purify you with certainty, with yaqeen. Surah Al-Fatiha, Al-Kafiyah. Kafiyah يعني إيه؟ It is enough with its meaning itself, and it is enough for you when you read it for yourself. It is enough. You don't need anything else. But read it with certainty. So alhamdulillah, we don't know how to even to read it, how to recite it. You have to recite it in the proper way, in a good way, the way of Rasulullah, and with full understanding of its meaning too. And with certainty, you have to be certain when you read it. Why you read Surah Al-Fatiha? For shifa? Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Put your hand and read it 7 times. Huh? Whatever the pain or whatever you have. It is enough for you. That's why Al-Kafiyah will satisfy you. It is Noor from Allah. Light from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That light, it is good for the mu'min. The only mu'min, the believer, the one who get benefit from Surah Al-Fatiha. It is light. It is Noor in your life. Surah Al-Fatiha, subhanallah. And its secret in what? Because the secret of Surah Al-Fatiha is Surah Al-Fatiha because it has all the meanings of the Holy Quran. It is the secret of that surah. How? Let me tell you. As I said, it is the mother of the book. It is the mother of the book. Your salah, prayer, will not be valid and perfect and complete without reciting Surah Al-Fatiha. That's why we say 7 repeated verses. We repeat it in the Salah all the time. Your Salah without Surah Al-Fatiha will not be complete and perfect. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Hadith Qudsi, قَسَمْتُ الصَّلَاةَ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَ عَبْدِ قِسْمَيْنِ. I make the Salah between me and my servant half and half. Half for him and half for me. Imagine that when you stand before Allah and you start reciting Surah Al-Fatiha and you say, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. And you stop. The end of the ayah. Stop. Slowly. Think about it. And give time. Give yourself time because Allah will answer you. When you say Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Allah will reply. This is turn now. You finish your turn. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. And you stop. Listen now to the term of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is time now. Allah will say, Hamadani, Hamidani Abdi. My servant praised me. Say, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Stop. Wait. And Allah will stir now. أثنى علي عبدي. Allah, my servant praised me more. Again. مالك يوم الدين. Stop. And Allah will say, مجدني عبدي. My servant honored me. Honored me. تمجيد, تعظيم. And you say, إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين, to the end. And this is dua. The rest of the surah dua. And Allah will say, هذا لعبدي ولعبدي ما سأل. Whatever my servant asking, I will give him. Half of the surah dua. And the first half of the chapter, what? It's between you and Allah. You're saying something, Allah is answering. Allah answering you. See how the great, it's a great surah. Now when you recite Surah Al-Fatiha, I want you to feel it. Do say, حَلَّا رَحْمَنَا رَحْمَنَا رَحْمَنَا. Amen. What is this? Somebody will say, this is what they recited. Huh? Alhamdulillah. Ameen. Waladdaleen. Ameen. What did you get? Nothing. You understand? Nothing. You recite in different way. And if you recite it like that, your salah will not be accepted. You have to recite Surah Al-Fatiha in the proper way, the way of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. رسول الله said, من لم يصلي بأم الكتاب فصلاته خداج. ناقصة. If you are not reciting with in the salah with the mother of the book, أم الكتاب سورة الفاتحة, your salah is not perfect, is not complete. خداج means ناقصة, not complete. فصلاته خداج. فهي أساس الصلاة. It is without it, there is no salah. Allah will not accept your prayer. And it is again the mother of the book. In Surah Al-Fatiha, when you recite it, you understand its meaning. You have to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, rahmatuhu tasbiq ghadabuh. His mercy and his rahmah, Allah put it before his anger and his wrath. He started with what? Bismillah, ar-Rahman, ar-Rahim. الحمد لله رب العالمين. Again, الرحمن الرحيم. His رحمن الدنيا ورحيم الآخرة. Allah رحمن even for non-Muslim people. But only رحيم in the آخرة, thereafter with the مؤمنين, with the believer. That's why when Allah described رسول الله, he said, بالمؤمنين رؤوف رحمن ولا رحيم رحيم. فهو رحيم الآخرة ورحمن الدنيا. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. He can give the non-Muslim people, anybody sitting even partner with him, he's still giving them rizq because he's the Lord of the, he's Rabbil Alameen. Even if you believe in him or not, you deny him or not, he's still your Rabbil Alameen. Al-Alameen, all mankind, jinn and ins, Muslim and non-Muslim. That's why, imagine that in your family, you have like 5 kids. These kids, you are the father. All of them, mashallah, they are very beautiful kids, good kids, very nice. They are treating them, their parents very well, nice way, except one of them. One of them, like, they call it black goat in the family. He's very bad boy. And his father and his parents, they try to convince him to be good. He's not. In the end, they give up. But if you ask the father, is he your son? He cannot say no. His Rabb al-Usra, he's still his father. He cannot say no. He still have room. He's still eating from the father's food and it's taking care of him while he's still bad. The same thing I give example to you. Allah, our Lord. Some people, they are worshipping cows and snakes and completely away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's way. And Allah is still giving them rizq. Allah is still taking care of them. Why? Because he is their Rabb. Rabb al-Alamin. See, so we have to know that. But in general, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this surah showing you, in this surah, when I say in this surah, means in the whole entire Quran, because this is the mother of the book. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always, always, he's putting his rahmah before his anger and his wrath. His rahmah before his punishment. Rahmati sabaqat ghadabi. طيب, what do we have to do? هنا تستوجب الشكر. You have to be grateful to Allah then. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala still sabur, patient, very patient with you, you are disobeying him, you are doing haram, you are doing too many things bad, and he's still giving you respite. He's still giving you time. He's not hastening for punishing you. Almighty Azza wa Jal. Now you have to be grateful to him. Alhamdulillah, Ya Rabb, you are my Rabb. You give me a chance 1, 2, 3, 10 millions of times, and I'm still disobeying you, and you're still Rahim. You never punished me. That's why you have to be grateful to Allah. Allah Almighty said, فَذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ. Remember me with your namaz, prayer, your zikr, Quran recitation. Zikr Allah in too many ways. With your tongue, with your heart. Remember me. I will remember you with my rahmah. وَشْكُرُونِي. Be grateful to me. And do not reject my ni'am, my blessings upon you. My favors upon you. واشكروني ولا تكفرون ولا تكفرون. ف when you say الحمد لله, you feel it. الحمد لله. يا سلام. الحمد لله. Think about it during your calamity, your مصيبة, your problem. Problem, say what? الحمد لله. When you recite سورة الفاتحة, say الحمد لله. That's why from Sunnah, like Abu Bakr said, Umar said, Uthman said, Ali said, Mu'atiyah al-Ansariyah, wa Fatima wa Aisha. All of them, they mentioned that hadith. They said, Rasulullah, when he used to pray, كان يسر بالبسملة ويبدأ بالحمد. He used to recite Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim secretly in his heart, and he used to start loudly with Surah al-Hamd in the Salah. That's why one of the names of Surah al-Fatiha, Surah al-Hamd, the chapter of the praising, or the praises. Huh? Surah al-Hamd, Surah al-Hamd. Sometimes when we show some kind of gratitude or you thank somebody too much, he became maghroor. He became maghroor or munafiq. You see somebody say, MashaAllah, Jazakallah khair brother, MashaAllah, you're the best. MashaAllah, MashaAllah, you're the best. Sometimes you're gonna feel, oh, I am somebody right now. Maghroor, ego. I am somebody. But with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's different. It's different. Alhamdulillah wa shukri lillah. All the time. That's why Rasulullah said, all the affairs of the believer, of the mu'min, is good for him. It's good for him. And this is only for the mu'min. Whenever something good happened to him, he will be grateful to Allah. He will thank Allah. And whenever any calamities or bad thing happened to him in his way to Allah in this dunya, he will be patient. And both are good for him. فبي grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even be grateful to Allah Azza wa Jal. Praise Him even if your brain, your aql, cannot go beyond His qudrah. You cannot go beyond His qudrah. You cannot get the idraq of the qudrah of Allah. The ilm of Allah, the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or kamal al-uluhiyya wa idraq al-qudrah. You cannot recognize 100% the capability of Allah, the uluhiyyat of Allah. Even if you cannot understand that, but what you have to do, say alhamdulillah. Even if you cannot understand it. Can you know what is going on in the universe? From the small atom to the rocket to the mountains, you don't know. We know nothing in Allah's universe, in Allah's kawn. We don't know nothing. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us order. What is the order? Praise me. Be grateful to me. I will do that. Even if we cannot understand. We cannot understand. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, even if you cannot understand, even his rahmah, mercy, he said that dua, la uhsi thana'an alayka anta kama athnayta ala nafsik. I cannot praise you exactly, ya Rabb, as if, يعني, we have all the shortcomings, brothers. We cannot praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in perfect manner. He said, لا أحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك. This is what he said صلى الله عليه وسلم. If we come and see the meaning of مالك يوم الدين, when we recite مالك يوم الدين, giving you a message here. What is the message when you say مالك يوم الدين? Allah, the honor of the day of recompense. The only decision in that day gonna be in His hand, not anybody else. That's why in too many ayah, the Quran explained that ayah. This is the mother of the book, as I said in the beginning. How? قال in the day of judgment, وَقَشَعَتِ الْأَصْوَاتُ لِلرَّحْمَانِ فَلَا تَسْمَعُ إِلَّا هَمْسَا. In the day of judgment, the day of gathering, nobody allowed to talk. Just you're gonna listen to whispers. People will whisper. And they said, لا يتكلمون إلا من أذن له الرحمن وقال صوابا ذلك اليوم الحق فمن شاء اتخذ إلى ربه مآبا. Nobody in the day of judgment from the angels, from the Anbiya, the prophets and messengers, from all mankind allowed to talk in the day of judgment without Allah's permission. And you must say something truthful. Nobody can lie in the day of judgment. That's why Allah is the Malik Yawm al-Din. He's the honor of the day of recompense. When we say that Allah Malik Yawm al-Din, We'll say Alhamdulillah, Ya Rab, You are Malik Yawm al-Din. Why? Because if somebody in this life, worldly life, weak, being oppressed by somebody else, somebody take your money, talk about your honor, oppressed you, kill you, shed your blood, somehow you've been oppressed, you're da'if, you're weak. What do you have to say? You cannot get your right because you're weak already. Just say silent like this and think deeply and say, Alhamdulillah, why? There is akhirah there, hereafter. And who gonna be there? Malik Yawm al-Din. Allah, the honor of the day of recompense. I will take my right there. I will get my right there. When you say Malik Yawm al-Din, think about it. Allah, you are the only one who will be Malik Yawm al-Din. That's why in the end, when everybody will die, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will call the angel of death. Come, O angel of death. Who remain still alive? Who's still alive? Who remain? The angel of death will say, Mikael, still alive. Go. Take his soul. He will come back. Who's still alive? Jibreel is still alive. Who's still alive? Israfil. Go take his soul. And then, who's still alive? O angel of death. Said, I am the only one still alive, Ya Allah. And Allah will give order to him. Mut ya malak al-maut. Oh, angel of death, die. Die. And he will die. The only one will remain, Allah. The honor of the day of recompense. That's why he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لِمَنِ الْمُلْكُ الْيَوْمِ The dominion of the heaven and the earth belongs to whom today? Nobody will answer. And Allah will say, where are the kings? Where are the sultans? Where are the presidents? Where are the leaders? Nobody can answer. And Allah will say, Al-mulku al-yawma lillahi al-wahid al-qahhar. Allah will answer himself. The kingdom today belongs to Allah, the only one God, Al-Wahid al-Qahhar. When you say Malik Yawm al-Din, subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's the one who will count the people, the evil ones, and he will put them in the hellfire. And the one here, he will reward the people of Jannah, those who are used to do good deeds, and he will admit them in Jannah. Their final abad will be in Jannah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why, because we say, see, Malik Yawm al-Din, too many meanings now. Look to the Quran, the mother of the book, just said Malik Yawm al-Din, that's it. We're going to talk about Yawm al-Din, but Quran talks in details, a lot, ayat. For example, he said, Allah's comparing now, said compare, use your mind, use your intellect. أَفَنَجْعَلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ كَالْمُجْرِمِينَ Do you think we're going to deal equally with the criminals like the Muslims? You answer. Allah is asking you, of course not. They are not equal in the sight of Allah. أَفَمَنْ كَانَ مُؤْمِنًا كَمَنْ كَانَ فَاسِقًا لَا يَسْتَوُونَ Do you think the mu'min, the believers, those who used to make good deeds, they will be equal in the sight of Allah with the rebellious people, the fasiq? They are not equal. Allah answered that. أَفَنَجْعَلُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ كالمفسدين في الأرض أم نجعل المتقين كالفجار Allah will say asking are we gonna deal with those who used to believe in Allah's oneness and they used to make righteous good deeds and those who used to make righteous good deeds like those who used to corrupt in the earth they are naked of course they are not Allah will deal them differently Malik Yawm al-Din, the honor of the day of judgment. That ayah, it's a protection for those who've been oppressed by somebody. Those who've been weak in this earth. Those who are rebellious, the evil ones in the society, they are the corruptors. مالك يوم الدين. It's the balance. Allah will balance between people and the day of judgment. ونضع الموازين القسط ليوم القيامة. When you recite مالك يوم الدين, see too many meanings. Did you hear about these meanings before? سبحان الله. It's a balance. When you recite مالك يوم الدين, I've been oppressed. No, there is يوم الدين, the hereafter. And Allah will be the only honor of يوم الدين. I will take my right there. Don't worry about it. We're going to stand in the court of Allah. He will give me my rights. It is the mizan. Look to An-Namrud. He claimed his God. Fir'aun, Pharaoh. He used to claim he was the high God. يعني the highest. Look to people of Thamud. People of Ad, when they denied and they rejected the messages of Allah and their messengers. Look how bad Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them in very severe and bad way. And Malik al-Shay, when we say Allah, the honor of the day of judgment, he's the one he can handle it. And it's his for him. When I say I have my car, I have the keys of my car, it's yours. You can do whatever you want with your car because you own it. Allah is the owner of the day of judgment. When you say you have this abaya, it's mine. I can wear it, I can throw this, up to me. I can cut it, I can trash it, it's up to me. Subhanahu, you have your own house too. You own it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Malik yawm al-deen. Another recitation, he said, Malik yawm al-deen. Both the same meaning. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you recite Malik Yawm al-Din, is giving you some kind of comfort, confidence. Don't be sad. I am the honor of the day of judgment. If somebody did oppress you, I will give you a right. You're going to stand all in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala azza wa jal. And with Allah, nobody will be oppressed. وَلَا يَظْلِمُ رَبُّكَ أَحَدًا. Brothers, think about this ayat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the honor of the time and the place. مالك الزمان والمكان. Even in our life too. He's the honor of this dunya and the مالك يوم الدين also. A man came to one of the pious people, asked him, am I one of the people of الدنيا or الآخرة? That man asking that sheikh, am I one of the people of الدنيا or الآخرة? And the Shaykh answered him. He said, Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he made the answer and the balance of each person in his hand. You can answer yourself. He said, how? He said, if somebody come to you and give you money and you became happy, in the same time somebody come to you to take money from you and you became sad, you answer yourself. You are one of the people of the dunya, not the akhira. If somebody is giving you this, you became happy because you take it. In the same time, somebody asks you for sadaqah, and you became sad in the same time, you are one of the people of the dunya, not the akhira. Now that's why this is a balance. You have to count yourself. Subhanallah. One of the salihin, when somebody used to come to ask him for sadaqah, he used to say, welcome, 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 with a good smile. People came to take sadaqah from him, and he used to stand and welcoming them with a good smile. Why? He said, marhaban, marhaban biman jaa yahmil hasanati ila al-akhirah bighayri ajr. Welcome to the one who came to carry my good deeds to Allah without any asking for any what? Reward or anything. You're coming to me to carry my hasanat free to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why if somebody come to take sadaqah from you, you have to be happy and you have to welcome him. Alhamdulillah for that. We have to believe that al-akhirah, it is truth, it is real, the hereafter, and this is part or one of the six pillars of faith: to believe in Allah, to believe in His books, to believe in his messengers and the prophets, to believe in the angels and the jinn also, to believe in your destiny, good and bad, and to believe in the hereafter. Somebody denied the reward. I start with the reward first off. The reward and the punishment of the grave, he's not a believer. Huh? If somebody denied the hereafter, the sirat, the mizan, the jannah, the hellfire, he's not a believer of Malik Yawmiddin. See, Malik Yawmiddin, three words in Arabic, but we can explain 1 hour just for that. Malik Yawmiddin, Allah, the honor of the day of recompense. He's the one who will punish the sinners, and he is the same one who will reward those who used to make good deeds. That's why if we deny the day of recompense and the hereafter, why you're coming to the masjid? Why you are praying today? Why you're giving sadaqah? Why you fasting Ramadan if you're not believing the hereafter? Yawm al-Din. Why you come to the masjid then? That's why we come to the masjid, we pray, we make sadaqah, we fast, we make good deeds, because one day in the day of judgment, we're going to stand before Allah. We will be asked. That's why Allah is the honor of the day of recompense. Let's go to Iyaka na'budu wa Iyaka nasta'in. And we'll try to understand Iyaka na'budu. Oh Allah, Iyaka anta. As if you talk to Allah face to face. When I say, Dr. Ibrahim, Iyaka anta. Iyaka anta. Huh? I'm talking to him directly. I'm talking to somebody exists. Somebody is not far from me. When you say Iyaka a'budu, mukhatab, you're talking to somebody front of you. Wa Iyaka, again, Iyaka you, nasta'in. We worship you alone, khususiyya. Iyaka na'budu. If you say na'budu Iyaka, maybe we ghayruk and somebody else. But Iyaka na'bud alone. We worship you alone, khususiyya, khususi, Allah alone. Wa Iyaka khususi, khusus. نستعين. We seek only help from you. فون سي إياك نعبد تفيد الخصوص للعبادة. Just only our عبادة لله, for Allah سبحانه وتعالى. قل إن صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله رب العالمين لا شريك له وبذلك أمرت وأنا أول المسلمين. My salah, my nusuk, my life, my death, everything in my life belongs to Allah رب العالمين. There is no God but He. That's why I say, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدْ, just only you worship. My, when I slaughter, when I make hajj, when I pray, when I fast, when I make sadaqah, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدْ, for the sake of Allah. For the sake of Allah. إِيَّاكَ أَعْبُدْ, I'm worshipping you alone. I'm not supposed to go to graveyards. I'm not supposed to go to maqabir. I'm not supposed to go to that sheikh and this sheikh. This is shirk. And even when I make ibadah, it's hidden shirk now, huh? Showing off, look at me, this is now hidden shirk, shirk al-asghar, shirk al-khafi, riya, for to be shown, huh? People will see you. Like that man, young boy, he came to the masjid, he was praying. Two old brothers, they were sitting on the side of the masjid, they look at him and they've been talking about him. MashaAllah, this young boy, MashaAllah. He's making full khushu' in the salah. His salah is good. Perfect. These two older brothers, they've been talking about him. And he was praying, he was listening. And the more he used to listen to them, he used to make, oh, more khushu'. Subhanallah. In the end, when he says, Salaam alaykum wa rahmatullah, Salaam alaykum wa rahmatullah, said, guys, I'm fasting too. See, just not for the sake of Allah. It is for just to be shu'i, you know? Look at me, I'm here. It is not for the sake of Allah then. That's why you have to be sincere when you worship Allah. We know that last two ayah in Surah Al-Kahf, stealing us very important message. Allah will not accept your salah. Huh? The two conditions of the acceptance of your salah, what? Al-ikhlas, sincerity, and al-mutaba'ah, to do your good deeds according to the way of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Like the Rasulullah used to do it. What the ayah said, Abu Ahmed, فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُوْ لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ. If you really seek to meet Allah while he's happy of you, accept your good deeds. Number one, فليعمل عملا صالحا. Your عمل will not be righteous and good if you do it according to your desire. You have to do it like the way of Rasulullah. Number two, sincerity. ولا يشرك بعبادة ربه أحدا. He must be sincere when he makes his good deeds. الإخلاص first and المتابعة. الصلاة إياك نعبد. We only worship you. الصلاة أساس العبادة. If you're not praying, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept anything from you. Do you know why? Rasulullah said, between us and non-Muslim people, salah. If you leave it, you neglect it, فقد كفر. العلماء, the scholar, they said, كفر عملي ولا عقدي بقى. You're kafir out of Islam or just kafir يعني in action, not عقيدة, creed. Why you put yourself in that area? Scholars, they have different, too many different opinions about you. You're kafir out or not. Kufr is kufr. So that's why be careful. Salah muhimma, important. Without salah, nothing gonna work with you. Do you know why? Because salah in Arabic means connection. And connection, when you connect yourself with Allah, if you cut that connection, khalas, you're out. There is no help for you. Who can help you if Allah will not help you? إياك نعبد. When you worship Allah, especially in the salah, when you put your forehead down in the sujood, now you're telling Allah Azza wa Jalla, Ya Rab, I am fully have khushu and khudu to you. I'm gonna humiliate myself when I put myself down to you. It's a big honor, actually, to be abdulillah, to be servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because you put down the best of your body, your face. Allah honored your face. That's why He forbid you to slap somebody in his face. If you want to punish somebody, punish him in his hand, your kid, or somewhere else. But don't slap him in his face, because Allah honored that place. Allah honored this. And whatever Allah honored, which is your face, when you put it down to Allah, Allah, that's the best. That's why He said, أَقْرَبُ مَا يَكُونَ الْعَبْدُ إِلَى رَبِّهِ وَسَاجِدٍ. The nearest to Allah while you are making sujood. More you make sujood, more you make khushu' to Allah when you put your forehead down to Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to understand that ibadah. Allah, when we understand al-Fatiha, when we read al-Rahman al-Rahim, we think about al-Rahma. When we say Malik Yawm al-Din, we think about the day of accountability, the day of recompense, al-Hisab. When we say إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين, we think about what? Worshipping Allah alone. And Allah said, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. When Allah created me and you, He put too many organs in your body, right? Your kidney working, your heart working, your eye working, your heart working, huh? Your body, your brain is working, functioning, huh? Working. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forced these organs to work. Did you feel it? Huh? Did you say, let me go to recharge the battery every day for my heart to work? Because my heart is going to stop. It's working itself. Allah qahar. Allah forced this body to work itself. Because it's makhluq. Get the order by Allah. But your dealing with Allah, your relationship with Allah, Allah did not force you. Allah gave you a choice. He gave you a choice. What the choice? إِنَّا هَدَيْنَاهُ السَّبِيلِ إِمَّا شَاكِرًا وَإِمَّا كَفُورًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He put you in like a junction between two ways. Either you go to that right way or the left way. This is up to your choice. Did anybody force you to come tonight for the masjid, for this halaqah, for the salah? Nobody forced you. This is your choice. You come by your choice. When you pray to Allah, by your choice. When you worship Allah with love, by your choice. That's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's why He created the jannah and the hellfire. You choose your way. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يريد المؤمن أن يتحرر من ذل الدنيا. Allah wants you to free yourself from the humiliation of الدنيا. That's why He said, if you seek help from الحي الذي لا يموت. Allah, Almighty God. Seek help from Allah alone. Don't humiliate yourself. Don't put yourself down. Put yourself down only to Allah. And ask Him He will give you. And seek help from him alone. Him, or from Allah alone subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you have money, big amount of money, when you have that big degree, that power, that position, big family and tribe, power, when you will be free from all of these things, the only thing will remain you with you, the only thing will remain with you, what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But nowadays everybody, most of the people, they are depending on the means, al-asbab. I have money, I depend on my money. I have credit cards, I depend on my credit cards. I have degree, I'm a doctor, Mr. Doctor. I depend on my degree. I have knowledge, subhanAllah. No, this all asbab. I want you to depend, trust the Rabb al-Asbab. Allah, the one who created all of this. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Mu'min, the believers, always is turning his face to Allah, to the heaven, asking him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll finish with that, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. When you say, oh Allah, اهدني, guide me. He said, guide me or guide us? He said, guide us, not me. I'm wrong. The surah is telling you the importance of the unity. That Allah did not say in Surah Al-Fatiha, اهدني الصراط المستقيم. I'm wrong. I'm not اهدني. اهدنا, all of us. Means what? Ishara. Green light, oh, unity of the Muslim Ummah, even in your dua. Ihdina, when you make dua for the brother in Palestine, Masjid Al-Aqsa, same make dua for the brother in Burma, in Afghanistan, in Syria, in Egypt, Lebanon, all Pakistan, Sri Lanka, wherever around the world, Muslims, make dua for them. Make dua for them. Ihdina, oh Allah, guide us, Allah, give us. This is a way. When Allah say, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. Oh Allah, guide us to the straight way or path. الهداية, guidance, two types. هداية دلالة وهداية معونة. Number, first type of guidance, the guidance of what? دلالة. دلالة means what? Somebody guiding you. Like what? Messenger, book, sheikh, scholar, imam, somebody has wisdom, he can guide you, your father, your son also, somebody, so Allah give him knowledge, he's reminding you and guiding you. Dilala, like what? You're living in Texas and you came to California for the first time in your life and you're asking about the bus station or the airport, you don't know what is the airport, and you know somebody, like anybody lives in the community, Dr. Ibrahim, مثلا. Doctor, please, could you guide me? Where is that? طبعا, we have navigation now, we have everything. This for دلالة too. مثلا يعني. Somebody doesn't know how to use the navigation or the internet. Guide me, where is the airport? He will tell you, go from that street. And now he's دليل now. دليل now. دلالة. Go that way, this way, and then you will be there. This هداية دلالة. And for this is for all mankind, everybody. Everybody can use this هداية. But second one for just only you, the mu'min. Hidayat ma'una, the guidance of help from Allah. Allah only helping the mu'mini to be guided. That's why he said, وَالَّذِينَ اهْتَدَوْا, those who been guided, Allah increased their hidayah. زَادَهُمْ هُدَى وَآتَاهُمْ تَقْوَاهُمْ وَآتَاهُمْ تَقْوَاهُمْ. Al-hidayah, when you say الصراط المستقيم, what is الصراط المستقيم? Spiritually, الصراط المستقيم, the way of Allah. We did not see الصراط المستقيم, but we feel it inside our hearts. When you pray, when you read the Quran, when you make good deeds, when you do all of that stuff, you are in الصراط المستقيم actually. But in the day of judgment, الصراط المستقيم will be physical way, bridge above the hellfire. And if you will not be in الصراط المستقيم in this life, you will never be there in الصراط المستقيم. الصراط will not be مستقيم for you. Will be in big trouble. That's why spiritually, as much as you can, try to be in the straight path. And the الصراط المستقيم, on the straight path, سبحان الله, it's a very short way. But now I can tell you the shortest way to Jannah, الصراط المستقيم, not the crooked way. If you will be crooked, yeah, we hanky banky, and you're gonna play around and you're gonna be right and left, up and down, you're falling yourself. The shortest way to go to Allah, الصراط المستقيم. Very important. الصراط المستقيم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, if you will go in different direction, He said, you will be punished in this dunya, life and hereafter. وَمَنْ يَعْشُ عَنْ ذِكْرَ الرَّحْمَنِ نُقَيِّضْ لَهُ شَيْطَانًا فَهُوَ لَهُ قَرِينٌ. If you neglect ذكر الله, you're not coming to the masjid. You give your Quran behind your back, you put it behind your back. You are away, astray from Allah's way, from الصراط المستقيم. You, Allah will appoint shaitan with you. Shaitan with you. And that shaitan will lead you to the hellfire, wal'azu billah. طيب. We'll finish with this inshallah. And we'll finish Surah Al-Fatiha today with that. What is الصراط المستقيم? Allah said, صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم. The way of those being bestowed. The favors of Allah. Allah bestowed them His favors and the blessing and rahmah. Who? Another verse in the Quran. Explain that ayah. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولِ وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولِ فَأُولَئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ وَحَسُنَ أُولَئِكَ رفيقا.